from WPTV. This is Today on 5 at 11.
Coming up, the expansion of high-speed rails in South Florida.
We're discussing the economic impact of Virgin Trains on downtown West Palm Beach and how that railway is contributing to the city's future.
Within a few weeks, Florida's Virgin Trains USA is expected to start construction of new high-speed rails between West Palm Beach and Orlando. The railway, formerly known as Brightline, got an infusion of funding when Virgin Group CEO Sir Richard Branson announced his partnership. The expansion will link Orlando, West Palm Beach, Fort Lauderdale, and Miami. The rail line's starting and ending point is adjacent to the massive Miami World Center. And we're joined today by Brian Glazer, who's the spokesperson for Miami World Center. This is big stuff for all of South Florida. Talk about the economic impact that this is going to have.
I think the economic impact is significant, and people are beginning to see it. All around the train stations in Miami, Fort Lauderdale, and here in West Palm Beach, what you're seeing is the beginning of a new urban core. All of these downtowns are beginning to see construction for retail, residential, restaurants, hospitality, hotels, and all of this for Virgin Trains is beginning to build a new urban core. The construction in West Palm Beach, for example, is joining Clematis Street. It's joining downtown and City Place. It's becoming the centerpiece for all of these cities and here in West Palm Beach. And what you're seeing is new jobs and new revenues.
But, you know, talk about the World Center project. Why would people in our area, 70 to 100 miles away, why should they care about it?
Let me first describe what Miami World Center is. Miami World Center is America's second largest urban development. It is Florida's biggest building project. It is a city within the city of the future, as termed by Departures magazine. And it's sort of, many have called it, the new Manhattanization of Miami. What you're seeing is that we have 11 buildings that compose Miami World Center on 27 acres, which was filled with decaying warehouses. And what you're seeing is, shall we say, a new entertainment, residential, retail, hospitality, and transportation complex, all built within the city of Miami in an area that was barren just one block west of the American Airlines Arena. I think we're seeing pictures of Brightline right now, but if we could show some pictures of Miami World Center, because I want to sort of describe for you that Miami World Center, in the center of it, is Paramount Miami World Center.
Right. I don't mean to interrupt you, but there's also a landing strip for cars. I mean, is that a gimmick or is that
No,
for
Paramount
real?
Miami World Center is a 60-story, 700-foot condo tower. It's the most heavily amenitized, and it does have a flying cars skyport. You can fly in, land on the roof, and then go downstairs into your condo. And someday, we will see flying cars in South Florida where we have an extensive problem with ground transportation. You said, why should people care? Miami is becoming the capital of the megalopolis of South Florida.
And it all ties in together. We could talk about this for a half hour, but they're telling us we've got to wrap it up.
Just make sure that you come see us at Miami World Center and you support Virgin Trains, because it's going to really make South Florida something very different for the future.
Will do. Tell Sir Richard Branson we say hello.
I will tell the people. I will tell Ben Porritt, who talks to Mr. Branson down in Miami every day, to say hello to him, and thanks so very much.
Down the chain of commands. All right, thank you so much for being here and telling us about it.